A very warm hello to all my TLC friends. I'm Dr. Seema Bajaj from Team Doc Talk. I work as a senior eye specialist with the ESI Hospital in Rohini, New Delhi. Today, very briefly, I'll be discussing about severe visual impairment, commonly called blindness. How do you define blindness? The World Health Organization has defined blindness as a vision of less than 3/60 in the better eye. Now, what does this mean? It means that what we can see at a distance of 60 meters, a blind person is unable to see even at a distance of 3 meters. In plain words, he is unable to count fingers in daylight at a distance of 3 meters with his better seeing eye. So you can imagine the impact this has on his day-to-day activities that are dependent on sight, like, say, traveling to work alone, looking after his family, cooking, reading, watching TV, using the mobile. The impact that blindness has on this person's life and on the life of his immediate society is huge. As of 2019, India had about 5 million blind, according to this WHO definition. We now come to the causes of blindness. This I'll be explaining to you with the help of this pie chart. As you can see, the major cause of blindness in India still continues to be cataract or Safed Motiyabind. This accounts for about 63% of the cases of blindness. This is followed by refractive errors, which account for about 20% of the cases. These are those conditions of the eye which can easily be corrected by spectacles, but when not, they can lead to blindness eventually. This is followed by glaucoma or Kala Motiyabind, which accounts for about 6% of the cases. Corneal blindness, or blindness in which the transparent portion of the eye, which we commonly call the putni, becomes white and opaque and light cannot enter the eye, accounts for about 1% of the cases. Besides these, there are several other miscellaneous causes for blindness which we have put together. These include injuries to the eye, which could be chemical injuries to the eye, injuries due to sharp objects. These could be post-op complications. They could be damage to the retina, what we call as the parda of the eye, due to diabetes and other systemic conditions, and age-related changes in the retina of the eye. Now that we know the causes of blindness, we will talk about its management. India has a very effective and successful program for the management and control of blindness called the National Program for Control of Blindness. The good news is that the major cause of blindness, that is cataract, is completely treatable by surgery and implantation of an intraocular lens when performed in the hands of a trained eye surgeon. This will be discussed in detail by Dr. Sanjay and Dr. Ekta in the upcoming video. The other causes of blindness, like refractive errors, glaucoma, diabetic changes in the eye, age-related changes in the eye, will also be discussed in the upcoming videos of Doc Talk. Now, the major stumbling block in the management of blindness in our country still remains corneal blindness, though it accounts for only 1% of the cases. Why so? Because though in cataract, which is the major cause, it is still completely treatable by implantation of an intraocular lens following cataract surgery. This intraocular lens is an artificial lens. Unlike this, corneal surgery for correction of corneal blindness requires a donor cornea from a dead person. India is still far lagging behind in corneal donation. Corneal blindness and eye donation will now be discussed in detail by Dr. Shilpi. So over to Dr. Shilpi.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shilpi Devan, ophthalmologist practicing in New Delhi. I specialize in cornea and refractive surgeries. Today, I'll be speaking on a topic which is very important for all of us as humans and as a society. I'll be talking on eye donation and cornea transplant. To get a basic understanding, let's first understand what is cornea and what is corneal blindness. Cornea is the anterior 1/5 of the outermost layer of the eyeball, which is transparent in nature. Because of its transparency, it allows the light to pass inside the eye and that enables us to see. If due to any reason the cornea loses its transparency and becomes opaque due to infection, injuries, drug reaction, or any other reason. Then the eyesight is compromised. This is known as corneal blindness. The only viable option to treat the corneal blindness is corneal transplantation. That is, replacing the diseased opaque cornea of a person with a healthy transparent cornea of a donor eye. India is estimated to have 15 million blind people, and 1% of this total blindness is contributed by corneally blind people. We need around 2.2 lakhs of cornea transplantations per year. But our current eye donation is around 63,000 eyes per year. So we see there is a huge gap between the requirement of cornea transplants per year and the actual number of eye donations. So to bridge this gap, the only option is to promote the awareness about and motivation about eye donation. Now let us understand about eye donation. Eye donation is a voluntary act. It can be performed only after the death of a person. Government of India has empowered the next of kin, that is the family of the deceased person, to provide consent for eye donation. Eyes can be procured for up to 6 to 8 hours after the death of a person. Eye donation is facilitated through eye banks. The eye bank is a non-profit organization which carries out the activities of procurement of eyes, their processing, evaluation, and making them available for surgeries to surgeons and hospitals. Now let me tell you what you have to do in case you wish to make an eye donation. First of all, call the nearest registered eye bank. In the meantime, make sure that the lids of the deceased person are completely closed. There should be no exposure of the eyes. If possible, place a clean wet gauze piece or cotton piece over the closed eyelids. Switch off the ceiling fan and keep the AC or cooler switched on. Elevate the head of the deceased person using a pillow and do not apply anything on the face or eyes of the person. Once the eye bank team arrives, the entire process will take 15 to 20 minutes. There is absolutely no disfigurement of the face of the deceased person. The procurement of eyes is carried out with utmost respect to the deceased person. After procuring the eyes, the eye bank technician will also take a blood sample from the body of the deceased person. In the last segment of this talk, I will talk about the prevalent myths about eye donation and clear the facts about the same. A very common myth is that eye donation has legal hassles and it delays funeral. Eye donation has absolutely no legal hassles. According to the Government of India, the family of the deceased person can provide consent for eye donation. The entire process takes only 15 to 20 minutes, so it does not cause any delay in the funeral. Next myth, that people who have diabetes, hypertension, or use specs cannot donate their eyes. Absolutely wrong. People who suffer from diabetes, hypertension, heart diseases, or had used spectacles can definitely donate their eyes. There is a list of very few diseases, mainly infectious diseases like hepatitis, HIV/AIDS, rabies, septicemia, certain prion diseases, and some other diseases in which eye donation is contraindicated. Otherwise, everyone else can donate eyes. Next myth, that eye donation can cause disfigurement of the face. Absolutely no, eye donation does not cause any disfigurement of the face. Next myth, if a person donates his eyes, he will be born blind in the next birth. There is absolutely no scientific basis to this myth. Eye donation is a very noble deed. If at all the person takes a rebirth, he will be born with the credit of this noble deed. Lastly, people say that eye donation cannot be done by women. Let me tell you that people of any age group, any sex, or any religion can donate eyes. I hope this talk about eye donation helped you get a clear understanding of eye donation. If each one of you is able to motivate even a single eye donation, that would be a huge help to humanity. Thank you.